We'd like to have a little fire out of here. Welcome to our 2018-19 Kaleidoscope concert. How many of you had a Kaleidoscope when you were a kid? Oh, I did. It's a lovely thing. One of those things where you sit and you turn and you look at all the images as keep going around. Look at the front of your program. Man, if you know Jennifer Paulson Burns, you gotta give our graphic arts designer in the district a lot of credit. That was her first time ever making a Kaleidoscope. So yeah, give her a round of applause. That's awesome. She always had found different kinds of things for it to be a Kaleidoscope before. And I said, this time, we're into the Viva La Vida. Can we do something with watermelons? Those of you with a painting, a lot of painting, do a little snip of that with all the instruments in there. It's really sort of neat all the way. The idea of a Kaleidoscope gives you a snapshot of everybody. As you can see, we've got a lot going on. This is 27 short days into the year. A mere 5 weeks ago, we were going, oh, by the way, the bathroom's over there, which is sort of a fun thing. Our percussion ensemble, yeah, especially in this school, 3,000 people. In the percussion ensemble, we have a unique bunch, and there's a lot of different sounds. You're gonna hear it three different times tonight. This is a little Caribbean music for your fall souls.
Thank you.
It's a lot of fun to do percussion ensembles. That's one of my joys. I always tell in this concert the story of why I started. I started teaching 29 years ago this fall in a lovely community called Lake Forest, Illinois. I taught there for 8 years. Lovely, lovely school. But I walked in my first band at Lake Forest. I had 54 kids and 13 percussionists. We really figured out boredom after the second day, so the third day we started our percussion ensemble. And we literally did. And from that point on, I've always had percussion ensemble as part of our curriculum and our program in different facets. This is a standing ensemble that exists as its own class. Because, you know, quite frankly, if we would try to push so many percussionists in all your hands, there wouldn't be enough for them to do, and they couldn't explore all this fun stuff. So you're gonna hear woods and metals, unique uses of railing on this side. A lot of standard battery that you would see in the pet band, Timothy, and some very fun cymbals and wind chimes by John. All right.
Thank you.
would play as one of his dances. And he played at various different tempos, sometimes slow, sometimes faster. It's in that ragtime style. The last one, I want you to make sure you read real close what the title is. Is the Roosters Really Do Lay Eggs in Kansas? Or some other things? You'll see what other things they do lay. But this next piece is what we're studying across all of the bands this year, European marches. We're going to do European march with all of them. One symphony, two or three, the one ensemble will do a couple as well. You heard one in the style of a European march a little bit ago, the Appreciate Zinger. It's actually written by an American, because Zoe Elliott was American, but he wrote it for the British Eighth Army, which obviously was a major impact in the war in Africa during World War II. So with that said, this piece is going to come from Spain, and I think you're going to hear has a lot of fun.
Thank you.
Scott Crosby, if you remember with our 90th anniversary concert last year, was saying, you know, you should have some fun with some of those older things that Suzuki used to do. What you do is you take that tune, and as you would travel with the Suzuki, a lot of times it would be in a rural community somewhere. So the roosters would lay eggs in Kansas, and that was the thing they would do. But that's how they would introduce all the instruments to the various different communities, and that's how they would do it. We're going to use that for a lullaby concert. It will also be with us for an encore for Funny Giggles. And who knows what Wyatt will come up with next away. It'll be sort of fun. We had an opportunity this summer to spend some time in a place that's very near and dear to you, the Shell Lake Arts Camp. How many of you have had some of your kids up at Shell Lake? Yeah, there's a lot out there. Yeah, give a round of applause. So, I know for many years that place has been the place to go, not only for jazz, but now for many of the chamber ensembles and things, and for the last 20 years, a concert band camp, which has been phenomenal. I was up there, I wasn't actually conducting, I was a saxophone teacher, that's what I get to do, which is sort of fun. But one of the things I wanted to pass along to you about the Shell Lake Arts Camp is right now they do have a funding grant because the company that you've been in their facilities, they need some. I mean, in a big way. I mean, they really have an issue. And they're almost home. They're almost all the way there. So you'll be hearing a lot from us this fall about anything you'd like to do. There will be a few stories here in our community where the Shell Lake Arts Force is going to be here. If you'd like to join Greg Peel and some of the different people that teach at that camp and myself to support that, I think we'll have a whole lot of fun. All right. Well, as you can see, now we put a whole bunch of them together. So let's put a little savory. for Shell Lake coming up, and that was that the thing that we did on our concert band, when we combined both concert bands at the end, was the next thing, Viva La Vida, because we were working with this wonderful, wonderful conductor from Spain. So Tony borrowed out parts of that and got me hooked on some wonderful Spanish music as well. So everybody, raise the curtains and see what we created.
Thank you.
kind of the proper girth, so you can see the whole picture. The name of this concert is a lot of fun for us. How many of you had a kaleidoscope when you were kids?
I did. I had a love of them. I played with that thing for hours. I'd turn it and look at all the different designs and things. You know, hey, did you take a look at the front of that program? Look at that thing. That's really cool. Jennifer Paulsenberg is our graphic designer here in the school district. And I said, geez, can you make a kaleidoscope this year? And she said, I don't know, let me see. And so she figured out how to do that. And if you look at it, it's sort of neat because it's got the watermelon painting, the pillow in there that is the Viva La Vida inspiration for Coldplay. So it's sort of neat, and you see all the instruments in there, or at least a piece of it. It was a part that she used with rights. So it's a lot of fun. I always make this speech to any of you that might be freshman parents because we have a percussion ensemble here at the high school. The reason we do is my first year, 29 years ago, when I started teaching in a lovely school district called Lake Forest, Illinois, I had 54 young students. 13 of them were percussionists in one day. We started literally on the second week, we started percussion ensemble. That was the way it was. I always had one ever since I started teaching, and it's a joy for me. This gives these guys a chance to experience different instruments they wouldn't necessarily see inside the other ensemble. So we're going to start this one off with a traditional Caribbean tune. If you turn that to other, you would hear this is called Mary. That guest solos too.
Thank you.
Some more traditional stuff you'd see outside with our pet band, which we call drumline.
The timpani has some really snazzy civil work and an awesome solo by John on the wind chimes as well. So I think you'll enjoy this. Jacob, let's have some bombastic. Thank you. as you can see, that harkens back to an easier time. This was actually a couple of the things that Sousa would do during his concerts back, well, over a century ago, when he would go and entertain the populace in little towns in Iowa, and then go out to big cities like L.A. and play in Paul Diamonds and things like this, because you have to remember, it was 100 years ago this year that orchestras like the L.A. Philharmonic were formed. So we didn't have those kinds of things, so Sousa did that for everybody. We do these dance suites, and these are very much ragtime kinds of feels. He also, and I want you to point out the program there, the final thing that we're going to play is one of his fun little delights called Rooster Lays Eggs in Kansas. We'll show you how many different eggs he lays, all right? It'll be a lot of fun. This next one is part of our European marches. You heard earlier, the Wind Ensemble played a lovely piece called British Aid. It actually isn't a European march, but it's written in the style of a European march. It was written by Zoella, who was a gentleman from New Jersey, who wrote it for the British Aid Army, which played a major role in the campaign in North Africa and all over Europe during the Second World War. So that was written for in a British style or the European style. This march, a little different story, is in a very Spanish flavor. I think you're going to like our spicy trumpets.
Thank you.
That's one of Sousa's fun pieces. What do we do with that? See, that was a piece where it introduced things to the audience. Then he'd show the different audiences the different kinds of instruments. And what yes. We're going to have fun with that this year. That'll travel with us on tour, along with a few others that'll be like that. I'll bring our rooster. So can you give our rooster a nice round of applause? One of the reasons that we entitled this Viva La Vida, or Live Life, Have Fun, Enjoy Life, is because, and quite frankly, it's these kids here are really super busy all the time, and they just run around and they do so many great things. We wanted to have them sit and enjoy the fact that they do a lot of great things. And I was talking this summer, getting this concept of how we're going to do the Kaleidoscope surrounding joy, the idea that you saw in the first program, we played a piece called Joy with the symphonic band. A lot of those pieces are just fun. And I told the conductor I was working with, Michelle, I said, do you have any music that would be sort of fun? He says, why don't you do the Coldplay thing, Viva La Vida? And I went, oh, yeah, life. It's a lot of fun. So, that came out of my experiences at Shell Lake this summer with a wonderful Spanish conductor in when I was up there. I was actually teaching saxophone for that, so that was fun. I said, well, we'll go ahead and use that. So all these things are surrounded by this Viva La Vida, hence you have the Kaleidoscope and everything that goes with it. This next tune, though, has our percussionists in here, and we're going to spice this one up a little bit this time. This is Sacred.